choo-choo. And no, that was not me transforming into Thomas the Train choo-choo, or however you say it, is the fuel of the future in 2077. It's what powers vehicles such as the Rayfield, which is one of my personal favorite hypercars. The thing has 1,660 horsepower. But again, don't get your hopes up. Since Cyberpunk is going to be an RPG, it might take a while before you can get your hands on any of these special vehicles. They said in one of the trailers that only about 1,000 people own a Rayfield, so the top of the top, such as the leader of Arasaka or Militech. And hey everybody, Junjoto from NASA here, and today I'm going to be analyzing the driving, handling and physics in the newly released Cyberpunk 2077. Oh shiza, I'm sorry, I forgot it, delayed it again. Well, check out this video, it's relatable, link down in the description. Now, thoughts may be rambling inside your mind as to how the feck am I qualified to talk about the driving in Cyberpunk 2077. Well, I've played many driving games throughout the years, and I've seen the best of the best and the worst of the worst when it comes to driving, such as Watch Dogs, which I literally chose to run around the map instead of driving that game. Like, thank god it was free when I got it on Epic, so I didn't have to pay for it, because if I did and if I spent 2 hours on that, well, then I think I would have sold my computer. I wish Ubisoft would just stop releasing 10 games every year and just focus on one game for 5 to 10 years. Imagine what could they make if they put their powers together and just stuck with one game. However, let's go ahead and begin talking about driving in Cyberpunk, which is what you came here for. Since, as you guys might be aware, riding Roach in The Witcher 3 honestly just wasn't right. You can't really pinpoint what was wrong, it just seemed unnatural, as well as the overall walking in that game just really reminded me of one of my top games, Walking Simulator. So that raises the question, if the riding of one horse seemed messed up, how will they develop different driving mechanics and physics for all the vehicles in the game, which they said every vehicle will feel and look unique? Big promises by CDPR, I know, however we need to look at the bigger picture. The game has been in development for 8 years, literally some gamers may have died in that period, and the game has been golden for almost a year now. Now, I don't really know what they meant when they said the game was gold. Like, what is golden? The walking, the city, or nothing? Since we got over 2 delays after the game went allegedly golden. Moreover, it is believed that over $300 million have been spent on development. Now, hopefully we're talking about development here and not advertising, because, oh, have they done a lot of that? My only fear is, what if, when the game comes, the game was overhyped? And I'm not the what if channel, so we're gonna stop right there. Now, after Night City Wire episode 4, we formally got introduced to the 5 vehicle classes in the game, which I actually won't go over since many YouTubers have already done so before me. But with the vehicles introduced and the process behind creating them shown, we can really see just how much effort, time, sweat and tears they have put into the vehicles. CDPR made sure that all the vehicles have unique handling, extremely detailed interiors, different sounds for different models, and crazy good looking exteriors. Basically, for a game that's not focused on driving, they really did their best to make sure everything looks, sounds, and plays the way it's supposed to. Now, we're gonna talk about the plays part, but before we do, kudos to them for putting so much effort into the vehicles compared to GTA, which has very repetitive, extremely undetailed interiors, and basically gave the same handling and sounds for every car. So if someone gave you headphones and put you in a GTA 5 car, you would not have the ability to tell if you're driving a supercar or a broke down Yugo. Now, the developers of Cyberpunk have stated that they are working to make the driving more realistic than something like GTA, which I get where they're coming from. When you start a car in GTA, it instantly starts drifting in place and turning and all that, but it still manages to feel extremely realistic. And I believe that is due to the amazing asphalt, the amazing tire design, smoke, and overall the game's physics. Yes, when you're falling it seems like you are floating, but Rockstar have done a great job, and it's nice, cause you see yourself go airborne in the air. I feel like sometimes some games truly miss the point and just stick you to the ground all the time, making the handling seem really jerky, and you guys will see what I'm talking about, because we can see this in the newly released Cyberpunk Xbox gameplay. literally released today, a couple of hours ago. The gameplay was overall great. We got some more dialogue with Johnny the Rocker Boy Silverhand. Some of the animations when talking to NPCs did seem a little clunky, but overall, everything else seemed smooth. Except the driving. It was too smooth and too rugged at times. I believe my problem personally with driving and handling is that it kinda seems like you're floating. Like when you're turning around the corners and speeding up from rest, like starting your car and then just speeding up, it just doesn't look right. It kind of reminds me of Watch Dogs, which as I said, I chose to run the map instead of driving that game. Now maybe the floating is just an illusion because the tires are so smooth and the asphalt has no holes. I really don't know what it is. And also, whenever there was an incline on the road or a downward slope, it just felt like the car would stick to it instantaneously in a jerky motion. It was like gravity was pulling you inward and is about to break your car. Again, you really can't pinpoint what is wrong. Like, thousands of hours went into development, but just something doesn't feel right. It's like when you're watching a movie with a green screen, and something about the background or the character in front just doesn't feel the way it's supposed to. And another small pet peeve I have is the way some of the economy cars look. I don't know, they just look like they've been taken out of one of those 1980s post-apocalyptic movies. That could be because it might have a 1980s vibe, I don't know, which is again kinda wrong. Like, I'm sure no car in the future would ever look like that with wires coming out of it. Like, I get it, it's cheap, but it just doesn't seem right. Like, do cheap cars now look like that? No, they don't. I don't think they're ever gonna look like that. However, I'm gonna stop rambling now, because that was it for this video, guys. Hopefully, you guys agreed with my thoughts. And if not, go ahead and let me know your thoughts on the driving, handling, and physics mechanics down in the comment section, because I really wanna know what you guys thought on the trailers, the gameplay videos, and all that on the driving. Because as I said, if you're buying this game with so much hype, 8 years of development, $300 million behind it, the driving needs to be good, obviously, because that is your only way of transportation around Night City. So that was it for this video, guys. If you enjoyed, leave a like, subscribe to the channel, and I'm going to see you in the next one. Stay healthy, have a nice rest of your day. Bye-bye.